Hello dear students, today we would be starting with chapter 3, that is Friendship and Duty. Activity 1. William Sidney Porter, better known by the pen name O. Henry, was an American writer. O. Henry's short stories are known for their wit, wordplay, warm characterization and clear twist endings. He was born on 11 September 1862 in North Carolina and died on 5th June 1910. From December 1903 to January 1906, O. Henry wrote a story a week for the New York Word magazine and published several short stories in other magazines. Some of his famous stories are The Last Leaf, The Gift of the Maggie, The Furnished Room, Cabbages and Kings. The story After 20 Years has the typical O. Henry twist. However, the characters portrayed could well make us reflect on our values. So, this is what we would be learning about in activity 2, and here there are short questions for you in the textbook which you can do on your own. We would be doing activity 2, that is After 20 Years by O. Henry. I would be explaining you with the help of a short movie. The cop moved along the street looking strong and important. This was the way he always moved. He was not thinking of how he looked. There were few people on the street to see him. It was only about 10 at night, but it was cold and there was a wind with a little rain in it. Now they're explaining everything. He stopped at doors as he walked along, trying each door to be sure that it was closed for the night. Now then he turned and looked up and down the street. He was a fine looking cop, watchful, guarding the peace. Now they're explaining what he was doing. People in this part of the city went home early. Now and then you might see the lights of a shop or a small restaurant, but most of the doors belong to business places that had been closed hours ago. Now they are saying what kind of city it was, okay? And then the cop suddenly slowed his walk. Near the door of a darkened shop, a man was standing. Now look what is happening next.
It's all right, officer. I'm just waiting for a friend. It's an appointment made 20 years ago. Sounds a little funny to you, doesn't it? Well, I will explain if you want to make certain that it's all straight. And about that, there used to be a restaurant where the store stands. Big Joe Brady's restaurant.
Until 5 years ago. It was torn down then.
Now students, as you have seen the man, what he looked like, okay? So here is his description. The man near the door had a colorless square face with bright eyes and a little white mark near his right eye. He had a large jewel in his necktie.
20 years ago, I dined here at Big Joe Brady's along with Jimmy Wells, my best chum, and the finest guy in the world. He and I were brought up in Newtown, just like two brothers together. I was 20 and he was 18. The next day morning, I was about to leave to the West to make my fortune. You couldn't have dragged Jimmy out of Newtown because he believed there is no other place like Newtown in this world. Well, we agreed that night, exactly 20 years later, we would meet here from that date and time, no matter what our conditions might be or what distance we might have to travel. We figured in 20 years, we would have our destinies worked out. Our fortunes made, whatever it may be.
It sounds pretty interesting. Rather a long time between meets. Though it seems to me, Haven't you heard from your friend since you left?
Well, yes. For a time, we corresponded. But after a year or two, we lost track of each other. You see, the West is a pretty big proposition. And I kept hustling around over it. Pretty lively. But I know. Jimmy will come here to meet me, if he is alive. For he always was the truest, staunchest old chap in the world. He'll never forget. He'll never forget. I came 1,000 miles to stand at this door. And it's worth it if my old chap turns up. It's 3 minutes to 10. It was exactly at 10 o'clock when we parted from here at this restaurant door. Wow.
Did pretty well out west, didn't you?
You bet. I hope Jimmy might have done half as well.
I'll be on my way. Hope your friend comes around all right. Going to call time on him shop?
I should say not. I'll give him half an hour at least. If Jimmy is alive on this earth, he'll be here by that time. So long, officer.
Good night, sir.
There was now a cold rain falling and the wind was stronger. The few people walking along the street were hurrying, trying to keep warm. At the door of the shop stood the man who had come 1,000 miles to meet a friend. Such a meeting could not be certain, but he waited now. He is explaining why he came, and such a meeting could not be certain means it is not a small thing. It is a very big thing and he waited for that.
Is that you, Bob?
Is that you? Jimmy Wells?
Bless my heart. It's Bob, sure as fate. I was certain I would find you here if you're still alive. Well, well, well. 20 years is the long time. All this gone. I wish it had lasted.
So long.
We could have had another dinner there. Well, how has the West treated you, old man?
Ah, bully. It has given me everything I have asked it. Doing well in Newtown, Jimmy?
Moderately. I work with the city establishment. Well, come on, Bob. Let's go to a place I know.
Yeah, sure.
We will have good long talk about the good old days.
Hey. You are not Jimmy Wells.
Well.
20 years is a long time. But not for a man's nose to change from a worm into a bug.
Sometimes it can change a good man into a bad one. You're under arrest for the past 10 minutes, Silky Bob. Chicago thinks you might drop her away. She wants to have a talk with you. That's what she wants. Coming with us quietly, are you? Bob, that's sensible. Now wait, before you take you to the station, I was asked to give you this note. You may have a look at it by this window. It's given to you by Patrolman Wells.
I was at the appointed place on time. When you struck the match to light your cigar, I saw it was the face of the man wanted in Chicago. Somehow, I couldn't do it myself, so I went around and got a plainclothes man to do the job. Jimmy.
So students, what we learned from this story is, friendship is important, right? But if it is your duty It should come first. Why? Because duty is the foremost thing. Okay. And this is what Jimmy Wells did. He was also a good friend. That's why he didn't arrest the man on his own. And he also was doing his own duty. Many of us probably know what it's like to feel compelled to do something out of friendship. Maybe it's working for no money, listening to long stories, or traveling hundreds of miles after 20 years. Bob clearly values the bonds of friendship that were forged between him and Jimmy all those years ago. However, it seems some of the knots may have come loose over the years that tied Jimmy to Bob. Now, loyalties. Loyalties to people and ideas can sometimes be difficult to maintain, especially when they are split between a person and an idea that might be close to our hearts. Keeping their 20-year appointment to the minute, Bob's loyalty to Jimmy is obviously unwavering. However, now that he's a policeman, Jimmy's loyalties to Bob and to the law are put to the test when he discovers his old friend is a wanted fugitive. Trust. Whom would you trust more? A police officer who arrested his best friend or a dirty cop who allowed his once closest friend or companion to escape? Despite what we might think, it's clear that Bob isn't able to trust Jimmy when it comes to keeping him out of jail. Actually, by the end of the story, it doesn't seem that Bob's able to trust Jimmy about very much at all. So this is what is all about the chapter After 20 Years by O. Henry. If you cannot understand anything in this, you can come on Saturday and inquire about the same, and also you need to write down the glossary of the chapter. Thank you.